We're joined here now, live at TAM 2012, with Rachel Dunlop, a.k.a. Dr. Rachie, all the way from Australia. How are you?
Hi, Chris. Good. Pretty good, actually.
Now, how long of a trip is this for you guys?
It's 13 hours from Sydney to LA, and then about another 45 minutes to Vegas. But all up, it comes around 22 hours with, you know, layovers and customs and all that sort of stuff.
And how many days are you stateside?
Seven. Yeah. So it's not bad. I'll probably get over my jet lag as I leave the country.
So how many TAMs has this been for you? Well, how many TAMs in the U.S., I should ask, and then we'll get into the Australia.
This is my third U.S. TAM, yeah.
Do you ever get used to that much traveling?
Yes, because I come to the States two or three times a year, so I'm kind of used to it now, yeah.
That's not too bad. Now, a couple years ago, I just want to plug this for a second here, because this is really cool. You gave a little Twitter smackdown to Mike Adams and Mercola. Tell us a little bit about what happened there.
Yeah, that's really funny, because that happened in 2010 when I won the Shorty Award for Health. And it just resurfaced, in fact, last week in Australia, because the anti-vaxxers found that article that Mike Adams wrote, the one about what skeptics really believe, which was taken down beautifully by Steve Novella, David Gorski, and Phil Plait.
They're pretty good at that.
Yeah, well, actually, there were a lot of people that had a go at taking that article down. But the one that David Gorski did was fantastic. It was like a burning straw man in a field of burning straw man of stupid in a black hole of stupid or something. I don't know if you remember that. In fact, it was brought up in a workshop again on Thursday. But yeah, basically, there's a competition called the Shorties, which is for the best short content on Twitter. And I won the category in health in 2010. But prior to me winning, Mike Adams and Joseph Mercola were sort of jostling for the lead, and Mike Adams got disqualified as a result of people setting up new Twitter accounts just to vote for him, which was explicitly against the rules.
Go figure, Mike Adams breaking the rules.
Well, you know, I mean, actually, to be fair, it was probably his fans that broke the rules, but you know, go figure the alt med crowd not understanding the rules. That's the issue, I think. I mean, it's not difficult to understand the rules. Yeah, so he got disqualified, and he sort of threw his toys out of the pram, as we say, and really had a huge tantrum and wrote about four blog posts about how evil skeptics were, which was hilarious at the time.
So now this is your third TAM in the States, but you also did TAM Oz, and was that difficult to put together at all?
No. I reckon we did that in an afternoon. It was pretty simple. No, we organized TAM Australia, which was in 2010, and that was huge. Like,
and not only that, but you can get the entire TAM Australia on DVD. Can people buy? I know you're selling them right here at your table.
Yeah,
right here, every single talk, except for one because of copyright something or another, right?
Copyright issues, yeah. You don't know what goes on behind the scenes until you've organized your own conference. And the fact that it's running smoothly here is an indication that there are wheels churning all over the place behind the scenes in this casino, because it's a massive amount of work to organize a conference like this.
Now, if somebody wants to get those DVDs, can they buy them online?
Yes, you can go to skeptics.com.au and go to our shop and you can buy them online. If you're at TAM, you can buy them here, but obviously you're not.
And we can hear you every week on the Skeptic Zone, right?
Most weeks, yeah. Yeah, I've been a little bit busy with work lately, but yes, skepticzone.tv for the Skeptic Zone podcast.
Great. Well, enjoy the rest of TAM. Thank you very much for joining
us
here.
Chris.